some Swift rings.
Okay, right, we started. Stream is live.
Oh, live. Shit.
Yes, it begins.
Blame Teapot.
Yeah, blame me. I had to go eat
something. He had to eat a lobster roll.
You're the reason Colin left?
Yep.
No, it wasn't me.
He says,
God damn it, Teapot, what did you say to him?
Can't stand that Teapot.
I know where Colin went. Did you guys hear
He's
about
on my
it?
Face now. That's where he went. I got him.
Colin's on the show today, everybody.
Oh, hang on.
No, Colin.
Welcome, Colin.
Yeah, welcome, Colin. See, Colin went into the Wizard's Tower. He's in the Wizard's Tower now.
Nice.
Yeah.
We'll eventually... is he going to be a raid boss?
Yes.
I hope so.
Is that what's going to happen? And he swings a sword at you.
That would be pretty cool. That would be pretty cool.
Yeah, and he only has one move, sword swing.
Sword swing.
Yeah, exactly.
He's a wizard, he'll summon a big sword.
That swings at you. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah,
he's gone. Feels bad, man. The living game is gone.
He's gone next week, but he's basically gone. Yeah. I'm a little sad. I'm a little sad Colin's leaving.
It is unfortunate.
Mm-hmm.
I like Colin.
He seemed like a really nice guy.
Yeah. He liked Mystic Builds. That's good enough for me.
Yeah, I mean, he still seems like a really nice guy. Like, he's not dead. He's doing something else now.
And, the reasons that he gave for, switching jobs or leaving or whatever, totally legit.
Yeah.
Less commute, more time with the family.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. It's very understandable. Very understandable.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Trading post idiots. This is so fun.
What?
Are you manipulating the market, Brazil?
There is a quip listed on the trading post right now for a 55 gold loss.
Why?
Wow.
Oh, because of what it costs to craft it?
No, because someone fucking, doesn't know what they're doing with listings.
That's what I mean, though. 55 gold under what it would cost you to craft it.
Yeah. Well, no, it's... I mean, yeah.
55 gold. Yeah, because they forgot about the listing fee or something?
I don't know.
Or the 15%?
So did you buy it, or what?
No. I'm telling other people so other people can buy it.
Go, guys.
Go.
Go buy a clip and flip it. There you go.
Yeah, and then while you're at it, buy 4,000 adventure runes. And
do you really want to do that, though?
No.
I don't know how you didn't make money on those adventure runes.
I bought them.
You didn't flip at the right time.
I guess I didn't flip them at the right time. I should have flipped them right after, I think it was Mordremoth? Maybe it was Meltandriel. Somebody on stream, in our chat, bought 4,000 of them after I had bought 2,000 approximately.
It was Modern.
I should have listed them right then. But
I made a small profit on Adventure Runes.
I made a small profit on video cards today.
I didn't buy as many as World of Enders there did, but
I did not make a profit. I bought them for 6 silver each, I guess, and they're down to 2.5. They're basically as low as they can be.
Yeah, they tanked really hard.
Oh, poor Mordremoth.
He suffered.
But if anybody missed the big news, Colin Johansson, the game director of Guild Wars 2, is moving on to greener pastures, apparently. And so they did a big Ask Me Anything on Reddit, which is that the first Ask Me Anything they've ever done on Reddit?
I think so.
I can't remember another one. I mean, we've been asking for forever.
If there was another one, it was before Guild Wars 2 even launched. So I think it was the first one, but if there was another one, it was more than 3 years ago.
Yeah. Yeah, but they've always been very tight-lipped about basically everything. So if there wasn't Ask Me Anything before, it didn't tell us much. And this one wasn't so bad. It was still, we didn't really get that much more new information, but we did get a few things that, that at least raised my eyebrows.
Absolutely.
So, okay, what about you guys? What did you hear in the Ask Me Anything that raised your eyebrows?
We're not going to fix dungeon rewards. We only have five people working on the game right now.
They said they are going to do that.
Yeah, they said it was unnecessary. So I think they do realize that it's an issue, and they're gonna probably.
I hope they fix it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Because I have had to grind AC tokens. I needed 1,000 of them. 1,000 AC tokens, and I guess I got 240 from PvP, but I was literally doing AC. I did it for the daily reward once through, and then I repeated it again for just 20 tokens each time, and then I did the PvP track, and it was terrible. Like, finding a group of level 80s is impossible. And when you do find level 80s, like, they don't have the expansion, and they have, like, 300 achievement points. So, like, a couple of times I got people with, like, mastery points and Heart of Thorns. Their achievement points still weren't very high. There was one guy that had 163, and he had 24,000 achievement points. But that was the only, like, outlier aside from me. But it's just, like, most of the people are, like, there were people, like, under level 30 joining. And yeah. There were people, I guess, probably the average level was probably, like, 45. And they just, like, they didn't know what to do, so I was trying to be, like, helpful and shit, because I have to do it. I have to be in that situation, so try to make the best out of it and help everybody. It's a win. But it was still so draining to just, like, it just, oh, God, it was bad.
So that was the consequence of nerfing the rewards, because I think they nerfed the rewards originally because they wanted it to be less, you know, elitist toxic. We're going to be doing this in 30 seconds or less, and if you can't do it, then you're screwed. And they wanted to be more like the people who wanted to experience the story, wanted to experience stuff, will do it because they like having fun like that. But unfortunately, it basically just killed the entire population of doing dungeons. And so all it left was... all that left was, like, a few people who, like, all the new players, basically, who see this little thing pop up in their mail saying, hey, look, you could go do a dungeon. And they're like, oh, what's this? So they go out there and say, so what's this thing that I'm supposed to be doing? How do I find five friends to do it with? There's nobody wants to do it anymore.
They only, people only did dungeons. You know, here's what's funny about dungeons is they've been in a sorry state since launch. They really haven't changed, with the exception of a path or two here or there. So even when you bring the rewards back, dungeons will still be bad, and people will still kind of dislike running them or be just as disinterested.
I kind of like dungeons.
They only do it for an overwhelming amount of gold, pure gold. Yeah. And that's why they did it before.
That's the majority of people. Yeah.
The problem is they're not going to revert it back to 100% where it was before. It's going to be some fraction of that. Yeah, will it be better than now? Sure. But what is the breaking point for players that say, okay, now dungeons are worth doing for me again?
I think what it's going to be is it's going to be they're not going to bring it up to, I mean, fractal rewards aren't that great either. They're going to have to rework that too. But they're going to have to bring it up to just under fractals, because there are people who don't like fractals at all. So people who don't like fractals and want the same rewards as fractals, let's say, would just go to dungeons if it was equal rewards, and it would draw people away from fractals, which is what they want to continue developing. They don't want to continue developing dungeons, so they're going to have to keep it lower than fractals, basically, if they want to keep developing fractals and not have to concentrate on dungeons. But it's got to be higher than what it is, because right now nobody's doing dungeons at all.
Yep. I was able to get groups for AC, and I was able to get a couple of groups for a friend who needed tokens for making either Quip or the Moot, one of the two. And it's a good thing that Quip got sold before the one that got listed, like, not too long ago. That's pretty funny. But, I mean, yeah, like, the dungeons past CM, like, no one does them. There's never an LFG. Like, I check a raw, like, a couple times, like, a week, and there's just nothing. Nothing there. Like, I was like, I'd totally do it raw if there was an LFG, but there's just not an LFG.
Well, this brings us to fractals, which is, there was quite a few tidbits about fractals and what they're trying to do there. And some of that sounds exciting, some of that sounds great to me, but we know that they're basically going to try and release, like, one new fractal at a time. When they do release new fractals, it's going to be like one at a time rather than several new fractals at a time. And that's problematic as well. Because if you release one new fractal, let's say, and it's not going to happen in April, so let's just say, I don't know, July. Probably not going to happen in July either. But We'll just use July as a fake reference. July, they give you a new fractal. So it's new content. People will go and run it a couple of times, and then that's it. Because there's not more than one being added into the game at a time, it's not going to be enough to sustain people to keep them in fractals for any length of time.
Well, yeah. They also talked about reworking the instabilities and reworking the reward structures. Hopefully they do like the perfect job on that at the same time as releasing the first fractal, because then maybe people will start gathering speed with fractals again.
Okay, fair enough. So for the very first rework of this whole system, which it needs, that'll draw people back in. But subsequent releases, let's say December's release, they only release one new fractal. Let's just say stabilities are in a magic place where they're perfect, which, you know, they never will be. It's a balancing thing, right? Mm-hmm. Let's just say everything else in fractals is perfect, and they just release one new fractal. It's just one island that they're releasing. Yeah. It's just not enough.
So the second fractal will be less of an impact than the first with the release of the changes. You're right. It should probably be released in bundles. The thing is, though, with that new, like, because we already discussed, like, when they release new fractals, they're going to have to rework the entire 1-to-100 system, right?
Sure.
So every time they rework, they release a new fractal, they're probably going to have to rework the entire 1-to-100 level system.
Sure. Yeah? But if you release a bundle, then you're doing all that work at once rather than reworking that system every couple of months when you had one.
And you're right, Rob. You're right. There's Richard. There's the additional problem. It's the problem with the names on the thing. The additional thing is that they were talking about the ones that they release are some of them are going to be reworks of things currently in the game. So if that's the case, if they're just releasing one fractal and it's something that we've already done before, that's not going to be that impressive. Like, we're going to be happy we got it, but it's not going to bring people back.
No, wrong.
Brazil won't be. I'll be happy that we got it, but, you know, I've already stated, it needs to be a bundle of fractals and not just one fractal, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Like, fractals started out as, like, I don't know, a teenager who had a lot of promise, who was making good grades, and then, like, he worked in a factory and got his fucking arm cut off. So then what they did was they, like, attached giant, like, crab claw onto his arm where his arm was missing. And then slowly he lost more limbs, and now he's just, like, this hybrid fuck-up of a mess. And that's what fractals are. Like, it's horrible. Like, fractals are a mess. They're shit. The rewards are shit. They're not fun. Swamp over and over. It's stupid. It's fucking stupid. The instabilities, I'll say this until the end of time, the instabilities are some vendetta that some dev had because he just had a boner for hating corner stacking, and that's all the instabilities are. They're to prevent corner stacking. So instead, everybody just spreads out around the room with ranged weapons, and I guess that's what he wanted because that's more complex, intricate combat, and there's more strategy to it.
Yeah. But, I mean, thankfully now we have raids, so we could actually have that kind of content.
Yeah, and we can get good rewards from raids.
Yeah, well, anyway, but at least now we have raids, so we have that thing that we have to have good strategies for, and now we could remove that crappy instability kind of stuff from fractals.
Yeah, and like 3% of the population can continue doing raids and having fun, and everyone else can just not do anything except go for their bugged precursor collections. Mm-hmm. So,
you know, that's actually a good point. Okay, so when they talked about fractals a little bit, I asked, are we going to get Ritlock's Underworld Adventures as a fractal? They said, no, it's too lore-heavy, and I was like, damn it, you might be right, but, you know, I feel like fractals should all be about lore because it's too story heavy, he said, but it should be lore fractals. I mean, that's the whole point of having a place you could go anywhere in the world, any time in the world. You could experience lore. But anyway, so that's not going to happen. So I then asked if it's going to be part of a raid instead, and that was not answered. But somebody else did respond saying, no, please, no, I don't want any more story locked behind raids. Because
Well, it's gonna happen.
It's gonna every raid's gonna have story on it.
Yeah.
So and I love it, but there was somebody like it was sort of woken my mind to the fact that there are a lot of people who don't even touch raids, and they're gonna miss out on some story. And it, I remember there was a they published a survey recently, I think, for raids. Some guy did a survey just from people on Reddit, so it's obviously not the entire community.
Right. It's just the whiny complainers.
Yeah, exactly.
It was interesting, some of the complaints with raids.
But some of the graphs that really opened my eyes was, okay, for one of them was, which bosses have you downed? It was like 90-something percent, or like 80 to 90% Veil Guardians down. Or I think it was like 98% got the Veil Guardian down, 50% got Gorsival down, and like 2% got Sabatha.
Mm.
So 2% of the entire population that did raids at all in Guild Wars 2 actually cleared the entire raid. But that's, of course,
not surprise me at all.
It does surprise me. You think that doesn't surprise you?
It doesn't surprise me at all either.
I think it's
I'll tell you why it doesn't surprise me. Gorsival, for groups who are slightly uncoordinated, who are not good at managing their actual rotations, who do not run the optimal builds, who do not bring the proper things into the raid composition, are going to have a bitch of a time every time he goes to World Shatter. I can tell you this because I've been in plenty of groups where this is a problem. And if you pug them, this is where they get stuck. They don't do enough DPS to change him, to move him around. And then if they do get to Sabatha, trying then to, you know, your general direction, knowing to throw east without having to think about which direction east is, Brazil giving me the crazy eyes, but it's absolutely true. That's a problem. That's what takes the longest time to learn, just knowing exactly where to throw. Now, there are tools in the game now where you can mark the map and say, throw heart, and you can just look and say, okay, here's heart, and do it. So that makes it a lot easier. But before that, I can promise you, my group, as well as many other groups, this was the biggest problem they're facing, is a general lack of awareness, I guess. You know, directional awareness.
Hmm.
So yeah. If they're not getting stuck at Gorsival, that's why they're getting stuck at Sabatha. And not only that, but when you get Sabatha into that last phase and all hell is breaking loose, people panic, right? Yep. You're getting her down to a very small percentage, and people panic, and they start to mess up, and their rotations go to shit, and they start dying, and they're standing in the wrong place, and they're not grouping up, and they're not sharing boons, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Things just go to hell because you're at the end of the fight, the timer's starting to tick down. Even though, like, the falling debris really doesn't do a lot of damage to you, it's just chaos on your screen, right? And people panic when chaos starts to happen. So, like, those are the hurdles that you have to overcome when you want to clear the raid. And so it doesn't surprise me that people are saying, Veil Guardian, sure, no problem, we killed him. Gorsival, for whatever reason, we're stuck at a DPS check. Even though Brazil has told us that the DPS needed per person isn't that astoundingly high, people just seem to have a problem with that.
Problem is, I would wager it is almost entirely player skill, because I would think that a lot of the people going into raids are using a build that they at least found on Meta Battle with at least exotic gear. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe that's not the case. Maybe people are just going in there doing whatever they want. But the people getting to Gorsival, I would think, are probably using something to what you would call a meta build. But the problem is, I use this example a lot because I play Warrior, and I'm very proud of my ability to play Warrior. Whenever fucking a Warrior's DPS rotation is this, whenever they go two hits of 100 blades, and then they just run around the room, and then they come back, and there's a whirlwind attack, and then they run around the room some more, and then here's a blade trail, and then they go around, and then here's two more hits of 100 blades, and then a dodge roll. And that's the rotation. No shit, you're not doing any damage. Like,
Gif it now.
Yep, we need that.
It's amazing. Well done. Yeah. Do Mesmer now. yeah, actually, Engineer is better. It's like 27 buttons, right?
Yeah, Engineer, like, people think because they're playing a Condi Engineer, they're doing lots of damage. And when you go into a pug, and, like, there are three Condi Engineers in the group, and they go to the Red Guardian, and the Red Guardian is at 75% health after Green and Blue have both been dead for 5 minutes? You're playing a Meta Engineer build with Meta Gear, like you spent 100 fucking gold on your Viper's armor conversion, but you can't play it, so there's no fucking point. So,
practice.
Player skill is probably almost entirely the issue.
Mm. Man.
Wow.
Well, I'm going to go back on that survey. There's a lot of interesting stuff. A lot of interesting stuff about that.
Interesting memes.
That was fantastic. Yeah.
That was a cheap okay, funny.
So it is. It was 2,400 responses, approximately. That is
a decent amount.
Not a significantly insignificant amount. Of course, it's all Reddit, so when you think about it, how many people on, like, what do you think about the people on Reddit? What kind of, it's people who are really involved in the game, mostly, right?
Well, vocal.
I'm not sure about that.
They're vocal about the game, like it or hate it.
Involved in the game,
mostly hates right now.
I can think of something that's really fun to equate that to, but I won't. I'll refrain, because that's a controversial topic. Anyways. Okay. Involved anyway, in the game does not necessarily mean skilled or unskilled. I'll just leave it at that.
Mm. True.
So have you tried Guild Wars 2? Let's pretend that the demographics on Reddit is identical to the demographics across the game in Guild Wars 2. Let's just say. So in this thing, we got who tried the raids? Who tried the first ring at all? And 20% only of all the people who responded tried the wings. So let's say in all of Guild Wars 2, only 20% of people actually attempt the raid. That's possible. It's probably more like 10 to 15, but yeah, okay. Do you plan on trying it out at some point? It's 33% yes, I'm not sure. Yeah, they're like, yeah, it seems interesting. Why wouldn't you? It doesn't interest me is 43%. Okay, whatever. Have you beaten all the bosses? That's weird, actually. That's weird. Have you beaten all the bosses within Spirit Veil? 55% say yes. And then when it goes down to the breakdown, only 1.1 say they beat Sabatha.
Yeah, I think someone clarified that in the Twitch chat a while ago.
Okay, what is that?
It was 2% of the people who have not yet completed the raid haven't beaten Sabatha or something. That's what Sherdil says.
Have beat... What?
2%
of the people who have not yet completed
the raid. It was not all people who
have beaten Sabatha.
Not... Well, I don't know. Yeah, so in other words, 2% who have not completed the full raid have... I don't even know what that means, really.
It's just kind of a really weird number.
But it means something.
So I've given up on this survey because it's flawed.
How is that metric even helpful?
I don't really know what that
is. Make sense.
Have you cleared the raid? 54% say yes. Have you beat Sabatha? 1% say yes.
Exactly.
It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah. It means they haven't beaten all the three bosses.
Somebody didn't kill Gorse of all, but they killed Sabatha and Veil Guardian.
Yeah, 54%.
54% said they cleared the raid.
Right.
Maybe it's
how are you clearing the raid? Kind
of people just troll entering Sabatha. The survey, maybe?
Maybe.
Maybe. Yeah,
it's that's the kind of thing that would happen.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
I mean, it is.
I don't know.
Yeah, it is. You know, survey that was put on Reddit. You know, it's.
I'm gonna read this again just to make sure.
Do it. Read it.
Have you beaten all bosses within Spirit Veil? 55% yes.
Okay.
Your rating accomplishments. Which bosses have you beaten so far? Tick all that apply. 1% Sadly.
Maybe it's just very poorly worded. If you,
maybe they just had a really hard time figuring out how to press the buttons. Okay, so I'm not going to take that question as... So let's say then that the 55% they have of people cleared the raid.
No,
that's probably wrong. That's probably wrong. Okay. No, forget this survey.
But the reason why that's surprising to me is that Veil Guardian is the Clown Fiesta boss. I'm just saying. It's the Clown Fiesta boss. It is the ultimate Clown Fiesta.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Savathur is definitely the second Clown Fiesta.
Yeah, once it gets tough, once it gets down to the nitty-gritty at the last 10-20%, right. it's crazy. But Veil Guardian... It's weird, okay? Because you spend, like, let's say you start doing the raid for the first time. You spend 8 hours, let's say, if you're a really good team, 8 hours getting Veil Guardian down the first time. Then you're done. And then you go to Gorseval, and then it's like a DPS check, essentially. And you can't get it down for a week. And then you finally get it down. Once you've gotten Gorseval down that first time, you know how much DPS you need to do. It's not a difficult fight anymore. You could kill it consistently. But you go back to Veil Guardian, it's not the DPS that's the matter. It's the mechanics that make things difficult. And so no matter what, you're still going to have a certain amount of trouble doing Veil Guardian.
I guess that's true, but I don't understand that really. Veil Guardian's not, I mean, I guess none of them are overly, like, mechanically wise.
None of them are bad difficult mechanically.
But, like, Veil Guardian is, for the tank to pull him at the right time, move him around the circle properly, for you to stand in a green circle and not let sparks destroy your group, and to DPS him.
This must just be salt, then, because people, I don't know, there are a whole bunch of people I know that have a bit of a trouble with green circles.
Don't get me wrong.
They have a phobia of them. Just
I definitely know. Like it's like on the attempts that you do mess up, it's almost always green circle.
It's green circle,
but
and it's mostly green circle. Like 90% of the time, the green circle fails. It's because it's in an area it's not supposed to be.
The tank sucks and the brake sucks.
So that's why in this fight, it relies on specific people a lot more than Gorseval does, and even Savathe. Because, I mean, in Savathe, everybody's got to know to throw it at a certain place. And you got those four areas. But that's not, like, raid killing, usually. It doesn't kill your raid. People could make up for that. But your tank has to be on the ball in Veil Guardian. And your four guys have to be there.
I think that's
totally, I mean, Brazil's absolutely right. If the green circle is in a place it doesn't belong... It's for one or two reasons. The tank didn't move it properly or at the right time, or you're not breaking that bar fast enough and he's sitting in that phase too long. Those are the only two reasons why the circle appears in the wrong places.
Hmm. I find, though, that you can kind of deal with the circle being behind if you just have appropriate professions to go for it. And if you got Reapers there, it's not a big deal if it's behind at all. If you got a Tempest, then you're screwed because he's just gonna die. I mean, I think Tempest is really bad for going to the circles, because even if you're not in it, even if everyone's in it, you still take a bit of damage and just kills you instantly. It's not fun. But if you have some professions with high hit points, it's not a big deal. Also, Twigs and Guns makes an excellent point. You know, the Veil Guardian, his pathing is just really weird sometimes.
It
he goes
is
the wrong way.
Bad.
See, it's funny because I've never had that problem with him. Apparently, lots of people have had that problem with him pathing weirdly. Like, once or twice in all the times we've killed him, has he, like, just gone off oddly? I don't know. It almost never happens to us. What does happen to us all the time, which seems to happen to almost nobody else, is Savathe just decides she doesn't give a shit about the person standing the furthest away and flaps right in the
minions.
Middle of melee.
Yeah, that happens a lot. That happens minions. A lot. Yeah,
I talked to a lot of people and they're like, they've never seen it happen. You know? Like, it happens every pool to us.
Yeah,
almost.
Same here. It happens. It happens very much every time. We have a lot of Reapers, though, a lot of the time. We have a whole
if
bunch
there
of
there are
Reapers.
Over, I think it's 25 targets, she just starts targeting shit that's close to her.
Wow.
I see.
And then if someone moves out, it usually resets it.
Okay. So I'm looking at the AMA summary now. So we got schedule as the as a main thing. So as the first little section. Big quarterly update in April to reduce grind and improve awards. Okay, that's getting me annoyed. It's coming in April, and I started doing my crystalline ore grind this week, basically. I've been going through the HOT story with every single one of my characters, and it is soul-crushing.
Yes.
It is soul-crushing.
That's one word for it.
And I can't, anyway. So in the DS, I found in this time, though, that doing Dragon Stand is not that bad. I don't mind doing Dragon Stand. It's kind of fun. It's kind of like you turn your brain off for a little while, but it especially with the build I'm using, it's just like flamethrower everywhere.
But you have to kind of pay attention, though. You have to semi-pay attention to Dragon Stand.
No.
It's nowhere near my level of leeching. I prefer things where I can just stand still for half an hour.
No, like, you could not really pay attention and still still help out quite a bit. Like, I was leading the boss team and not really paying attention. It's pretty simple Dragon Stand once you've done it a few times. So to get into Dragon Stand, basically there's like a 10-minute window every 2 hours where there's going to be one server that's chosen as the taxi server. And for 5 to 10 minutes, people are going to be taxing people in, and it's going to be filled up, and then you go. But then afterwards, like, you beat Dragon Stand, it happens every time, and you have, like, maybe, what is it, 10 minutes?
Yeah, probably.
On the map afterwards, where you have to blitz to try to get every single noxious pod you can, and then you're kicked out of the map with no warning. With 1 minute warning.
Yeah.
But it...
Yep.
And you get 1, 3, or 10. Now it got buffed from, like...
I get a lot of one.
I get 99% of the time I get one. Yeah. 1.9% of the time I get three. And anyway, it's
really terrible.
The rewards for the amount of time you spend in Dragon Stand, regardless of how brain dead it is or not, the rewards at the end of it when you're done that whole 2 hour block or whatever is very underwhelming.
Mm. Yeah. It's a long one. Yeah. Whereas Tyria, now that is an event you should leech. Now,
oh, God, I leeched that so hard.
Yeah. Oh, I'm staying clear of that, though. I don't need that.
But I was in a Tyria that failed super hard this morning.
Yeah. Taxi so Wars 2. Have fun with that.
Tag all the Octovines. I think they're AFK.
Yeah, they're on to me now, though. It seems like... It seems like a lot of the time, I try and you know, get into some maps, and then after about two joins, it says, nope, can't join any more parties. It's not going to let you in anymore.
It's just re-log the character select and go back.
But that doesn't always work.
It does.
It does sometimes, but sometimes it's
If it doesn't, then stop it. Just cut it out.
Cut it out. Stop leaving.
The point is, the rewards for those maps aren't that bad, because you can get those things pretty easily. Like, the Aurelion's not too hard to get, the Leyline Crystal's not too bad. You can collect those.
Crystalline ore is stupid.
Crystalline ore is stupid, especially since, okay, there's the Signet of Ruthlessness, which is the one that gives you 5 stacks of vulnerability on an interrupt. It's not that good of a sigil at all, and it's 100 crystalline ore.
It's very
nobody's gonna buy that.
Everything's overpriced. Everything's really overpriced.
I have like 5 of them because I did the HOT story eight times, and you could just select it. So I took that one because I'm not gonna get it any other way. And no, I also took the moon stealing one though. That's a good one, But no, there's no way I'm buying that. The ones that I do want to buy are the leadership runes, because they're fantastic. But they're also 100 each, and you need 6 of them at least to have a full set. And that's 600 ore. And you only get 40 for doing the HOT story. So I have 9 characters. I've done it on 8 of them so far. That's only 320. I need another 280. You get maybe 20 if you're lucky, to 30 if you're really lucky, at the end of every DS map, if you have the machetes to do it.
Yep.
It's actually
everyone's gonna know my name is Jason.
Yeah, everyone.
You're
knows
back,
him.
Aren't you?
Well, it's not actually me. The stream is still alive, and it has been the entire time.
No, it says RIP right now. Everybody's saying RIP.
Yeah, but I'm watching the stream right now.
on my. No, I'm watching the stream too. But yeah, Skype
it's just Skype. You're gonna have to put a bear and a bleep noise over two parts of this playback.
Really?
Why? My picture hasn't even loaded. I wonder if it's my fault.
I don't think actually anything got showed. So I think we're all right.
Well, I said Inks, and Brazil just said Brazil.
Yeah, Brazil's real name, Brazil. Everyone knows.
And also, I'm not sure that my real name is a secret. Anyway,
everyone knows it's Martin.
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 I had a really good friend whose name was Martin.
I'm Ben.
Was that
Jerry?
Actually,
I'm Jerry.
Said my name one time, and it made me.
He did. T-Bud, are you okay?
I don't think he's in.
Calm Johansson. Oh, it's your dream. Thank you.
Oh,
this is pretty unacceptable.
Oh, here we go.
Oh no, I can see Mighty Teapot's account.
Oh yeah.
Steal all his gold.
All my gold. You see my amazing hacks.
All that large amounts of gold you've made from raiding with salt.
Yes.
Your piles of gold.
I think I actually am in profit. Just probably. Maybe.
Oh.
By raiding.
Okay, are we back?
I don't know. I think I'm still out of profit.
I bought all my world's first food last night, and I am like I spent so much money.
You going for world's first?
It was over 100 gold on food.
Oh my God. Wow, that's a lot of food.
Yep. Brazil keeping the cooks in business.
So wait,
doorbell just rang.
How many hours worth of food is that then?
A lot. I have 100 pizzas and 100 crystals.
Yeah,
and like 50 bountiful cents. Let me go see what's at the door. Hold on.
All right.
Are we streaming right now?
Cards.
Yeah, it's back. It's back.
Okay, good. All right. So they said April quarterly update to reduce grind and improve rewards. Good. So maybe good. In April, the crystalline the crystalline ore will be either improved or the reduced price of the. Probably they're going to reduce the price on some of those ridiculous things.
They'll probably fix scribing at this time as well, because they said they would lower some of the costs for scribing. So I imagine that's going to happen in April as well.
Yeah, but that makes me sad because I want my leadership runes like now. Do you think I'd get like a refund if...
No. No.
What if I got a refund?
No.
Ain't it?
Not getting a refund.
That's not how they
operate. Give me a refund.
You know that's not how it works. That's not... No, that's not going to happen.
Fine. Okay, but it says after that we'll do live beta tests, improvements to world versus world. Okay, so... In the end of April, looks like live beta tests of the improvements to World versus World.
For the dub, yeah.
That is a good idea because I feel that the World versus World player base has a very good idea of what they want and maybe a better idea than ArenaNet has of what World versus World wants.
That last part is probably true, but yeah. They definitely need to get hardcore, solid, every week, every day, hour guilds in there that play World versus World all the time and get their feedback.
Yeah, fuck World versus World.
Yep.
Yeah, yeah.
And so, then Raid 3 is launched in May, probably, or June, probably around the same time the World versus World actually comes out.
End of May, right.
And then after that, Living World Season 3.
What the hell? Why is it so long?
Why so long? What's going on? What are they doing?
Remember, T-Pot, when before HOT came out, you're like, I have a theory that they are actually working on Living World Season 3 at the same time as they're doing the expansion.
Honestly, my theory was even worse than that. But it was far worse than you are even imagining right now. I actually assumed they had most of it done, ready to go. And they were just going to release it as the game goes on. A good amount of it, anyway.
Apparently, I told you. Not even close. Man, I wish, but I doubt it highly.
Oh, Dark Magician Girl.
Dark Magician. Someone says it was Brazil's new Dark Magician Girl fleshlight.
Didn't they should just put that in the game?
It's offline again, I think.
Yeah, I'm dead.
Open up Maya a little bit.
Oh my gosh.
Is Teapot back?
I am always here.
What is going on, man?
I have a good connection, as you can tell.
Teapot, I think you zoom me in too much on stream.
Really?
You gotta zoom out.
Are you...
I'm not a close-up kind of handsome face. I'm not good in 1080p. Here.
I am. The less of my pregnant man belly you show, the better. I was looking at some pictures from PAX last year.
Did any of you guys meet Inks before?
Damn, I'm fat.
In real life?
I'm fat, too.
No.
I'm like fat in the wrong place. I have a baby in my belly.
You're a giant. You are like 9 feet tall.
Inks is?
Inks is like 9 feet tall.
How tall are you?
He's really tall. No, like I come up to maybe, I came up to maybe his waist.
That's a good
one. Are you a minimum height Azura?
No, I'm like 5'8", but...
What?
Not much of a comparison.
No. No. Please, no. Come on, man. Sure. Your name is Ben and you're 5'8"?
I'm 5'8", yeah.
Ben-Hur.
I guess that's not that short.
Why?
What do you mean,
why? I
wish
I didn't know this stuff.
5'8". It's, in non-retarded unit. What are you, British? I'm 176 centimeters or something like that? Hold on, I'll look at the conversion.
I can't deal with this.
5'8" in centimeters.
Man, it's supposed to be at least 8 feet tall. True story.
Yeah, like 173.
I also didn't know we were live. That's too funny.
How tall are you, Brazil?
5'8" is above average, like thank you very much.
Okay, what about you, Inks? How tall are you?
I'm like 6'2".
Oh, shit. I'm actually about... Giant. I think I'm about the same height as you then, Inks. That's pretty crazy.
6'1", 6'2".
No!
Yeah. Yes!
Except Teapot is thin. I look like I'm having a child always.
Yeah, seriously, zoom me out.
What do you want? Okay,
baby calf.
Give me a minute.
I hate this.
Why do you hate this? What's the problem?
I don't like knowing stuff about people. I just want the stuff I have perceived in my head to be correct.
You thought Teapot was tiny? Like
yeah, I thought you were small.
Oh,
I thought
really?
Boots was probably the tallest.
I thought Teapot was tiny too, actually. Yeah.
God damn it.
I thought Inks was probably my height.
Brazil, I always assumed you were like 5'9".
No, I'm a little bit taller than that.
Okay. Teapot, I thought, was like probably 4'9", 4'10".
Really? I don't know. I don't know why. I don't ever think of somebody as being short. I don't know why. I just assume everybody is my height.
And then you saw me in real life.
And then I was like, oh, he's a...
God, Boots, if I ever see you in real life, I'm going to hit you in the face.
Okay.
I think it's very difficult. I think it's very difficult to perceive how tall someone is just by looking at them through a webcam.
Yeah, that's why it's bothering me so much.
Colin is very tall.
It's because I'm only a child. I'm only 14, apparently. Do I really look
you know
that
who
young?
Else is tall?
No, not Jebro. Again.
Jebro is also
Jebro is tall.
Not again.
He might be
dead again.
He might be slightly taller.
Why?
Not at all, but I'm there at least. Watching other people work out.
Bills and I have been working out at home recently.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Belly. I just can't. I don't know.
It's tough. It's terrible. I don't have one. Yeah.
And I'm looking, I was looking at PAX pictures of like me standing next to Ruby or on stage with Ruby, and I'm like, I am so fucking fat. I hate this. I hate looking at myself. I really do. Fucking.
What out of context?
I don't know. I'm big everywhere. When I wrestled, I was bigger everywhere, but it was like more square. Now I have like a former bodybuilder gut.
Yeah, you told me you were like... Before.
Yeah, I was I don't know, being in wrestling shape, as people call it. Mm. Like, you're not, like, you don't have, like, super defined muscles, like people that just do crunches and, like, curls all day. You're just, like, thick and very intimidating. Yeah. And so...
I've always been, I mean, I'm 5'8", like I said, and I've always been kind of, you know, wiry, you know?
Sure.
I was in high school and most of the way through college. I was very wiry slash toned, but it's all downhill.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing, though. Like, I'm able to somehow keep in shape, sort of, because I do like soccer on the weekends. And you
climb mountains.
And because every now and then my ridiculously athletic dad makes me do ridiculous things like 50-kilometer ski days or something. So, like, just out of sheer, I don't know, like, folly, I managed to stay in shape.
People are only catching like half the conversation. Do something about it, Inks. I do. I go to the gym every day.
Mm-hmm.
I eat terribly, so that's definitely part of the problem.
Yeah, you know, I think that's probably the main problem. That's the main problem, I'd say.
I'm terrible at eating. I really am, but I love food.
I do too.
It's terrible.
Me too. Food is some seriously good shit.
And I do. I do try to. I believe it or not, I do try to diet, and I do so for, you know, a while, and then I fall off the wagon every time. It's a good thing I'm not addicted to, like, heroin, because that would be terrible.
That would be. Although it might keep you in better shape, because if all you do is heroin. And,
Yeah.
You should take up smoking, Inks. Then
you should find a video game you really love and get a job there, and then get addicted to ruining it patch after patch.
No.
Well, they've just invented
internet in the UK. I heard him.
Yeah, I think I did too.
There he is.
He's alive.
Well, this is fun. I'm really enjoying myself here. It's good to have such a great connection, like the one I have.
Mm-hmm.
You know. Yeah.
My nephew's birthday is today, so yesterday I had to like overnight him a gift, and he's
you
really.
You could have said it earlier.
I could have, but I'm a bad uncle, so.
Me too.
So I sent him like a Pikachu. I was when Brazil pulled his little card box out. I sent him a Pikachu card box thing. He was very excited that he could put his Pokemon cards in there.
Good.
He doesn't play the game properly, but he was very excited that he could put his cards in there.
Is it just me, or is my face not my face?
Your face is not your face right now.
Are we live again?
Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
Okay,
we are.
So where is Boots? That is a good question.
Beautiful.
We need good Boots in this house, yeah. Shall we continue if we can, T-Pi? Do you think your internet will allow it if we continue with...
Flip a coin. I have no fucking idea.
Hold on. Heads, we continue.
Yep.
It's the queen, by the way. UK internet will decide this. And tails, which is a moose. No. It is a caribou. Means we'll just stop right here. Oh, it's tails. All right. Bye, everybody. It's been fun.
Well, it's lasted for nearly a minute.
That's impressive.
That is impressive, right? And where were we, anyway?
We were talking about how we were disappointed that we're going to have to wait.
Ah, yeah, Living Story.
A very long time for Living Story 3.
Yeah. Well, that is a true fact. It's a raid till the end of the next Raid Wing. Well, when it's released, anyway.
I hope the raid story is going to be good enough for me to not care about Living World.
I mean, it's just going to be a snippet, really. I mean...
Honestly, yeah, there's probably
there'll be story there, and it'll be like it'll probably be very interesting lore in, for those who are into that, but it won't be a fully fleshed story, right? Because it's being told over three parts at the very least.
I just hope it has characters that are better than Rox and Braum and Timey. I mean, like those characters could not exist, and it would be better.
Mm. But right now, there aren't any characters except the bosses, right? As such,
right. Well, I kind of like Knuckles, even though he's got, like, only a couple lines of dialogue.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah, there are some interesting lines of dialogue with regards to the bosses, especially on the Sabbatha champions. And that will be no doubt developed in as we go through.
Is there, I mean, the characters, yeah, it's true. It would be great to have an interesting character that doesn't just kind of follow tropes. Well, but I don't think that's possible.
One of the problems, you know, at least in my opinion, one of the problems is that there's so many characters part of Destiny's Edge 2.0, none of them get enough time to really explore them. Like in the expansion, you really don't hear from half of the characters very much at all. And the ones you do, it's very tiny little snippets of nothing.
Yep.
So they really don't change or develop enough because you don't get enough story, like, you don't get enough story time with them, really, is what it comes down to.
That's exactly it, yeah.
Well, I mean, I said that a lot. Yeah, it's there's no way they're going to bring Destiny's Edge 2.0 into the raids, though. So, Brazil, you're safe there. There will be no Rocks, Bram, or Timies within raids. I just... Cringe Fist? Yeah.
That's probably not where's my face? Seriously, Teapot, this is not acceptable.
I don't know. Do you want me to remove you and bring you back?
Can you guys see it? Can you guys see Boots? No?
I just see his logo.
Oh, hold on.
You don't have your webcam turned on, do you?
Yes. No, he doesn't.
I don't know what you're talking about. That's
that would explain it.
Hold on a second. Oh, wait a second.
I just want to go to sleep back here. I'm so tired.
I put a poster in front of my webcam. That was the problem. Here, I just took it away.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Do you have a poster of your own logo?
I do, yeah.
For occasions, just like this? Is that your wallpaper? Do you have just your kind of just, various just World of Enders images all over the walls? Just to remind you.
I could start making those. Would people be interested in buying some of that stuff? Because I would totally
t-shirts.
Make some.
Actually, t-shirts. Your logo would be really good on a t-shirt, actually.
Yeah, or if I could probably remove the WOE and it might still be good.
Oh, no, I think
people wouldn't know what it is.
Just the world. It would be pretty good, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, you're just the world, but then it's just the world, though.
Yeah, or like write it somewhere small so that people who don't want to be looked like someone asks what's World of Enders, then you don't have to actually explain it.
Put it on the sleeve.
What?
There you go.
Oh yeah. That'll be pretty.
Yeah,
good.
Like world, like the world, and then World of Enders somewhere else. Yeah, you could do that. Socks, on
stickers,
socks.
Stickers like I did.
To put in your boots. Great idea.
To put in your boots.
Yeah. That's pretty good,
good
huh?
stuff.
But yeah.
Good stuff.
I'm looking forward to Living Story, actually, because some other things got said in the AMA that suggested the world will be changing, permanent change to old and new maps. And that's what I like. That's pretty cool, I think.
They've been doing that already, though. It's not like...
Yeah, but now they're going to do it again.
But I am... I think they said possibly old maps. They said definitely on the new maps there will be permanent change, but they said possibly to the old maps.
But that means they want to do it, right? That means they want to do it, but they don't want to promise it.
But that's the question, though. Like that was the original question I had before the expansion, is would they be making changes to the old maps, considering that the people who haven't bought the expansion yet would get access to it in that case? And do they want to give access to people... who haven't bought the expansion to stuff from the expansion.
If you don't change the world, though, it feels stagnant.
Yeah, that's true.
To a certain extent, you could just get no rewards. You could just get no rewards from doing it. It would just be pointless for them to do it.
Or you just can't talk to some of the people. Yeah, they don't say anything for people.
Yeah.
You don't get rewards anyway.
Or just hide it behind gliders or something. Mushrooms. Something like
that. Yeah, totally.
Speaking of gliders, I think Brazil, maybe as Banks said, they think that the legendary back piece is probably also going to be a glider. And they were right.
I had a good discussion the other day. The Spinal Blade's back pieces should be a glider.
It's going to be. That's what they said.
No.
Oh, not the Spinal Blades. Oh, right. Why would the Spinal Blades have kind of like a jetpack attached to it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay.
The Molten Jetpack should be a glider.
Definitely.
Holy shit.
Definitely.
Oh, man.
It would make it even more unobtainable.
If we said you're good.
How much do those cost now?
Like 2K, probably?
Yeah. It's expensive.
They're down to 2K.
They're down to 2K.
Yeah.
All the Halloween skins tanked.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because they got reintroduced, didn't they?
No.
Like, how much are generosity runes now?
I don't know.
I don't know. How much are they, Boots?
I'm looking it up.
All right, do
sigil,
it.
Sorry, sigil.
Yeah, sigil of generosity.
Internet is slow. What is this? This is... What the hell is this?
Ah, sweet, sweet loot.
This page did not load properly. Well, I think my internet's going bad now, too.
Uh-oh, it's spreading.
Get your ass back here.
38 silver.
38 silver?
So, from 80 gold to 38 silver.
Wow.
Boom.
They got right.
Boom. Yeah, and that happened to everything. While we're at it, let's do a pass of all the sigils and runes in the game and get rid of, like, at least.
Yeah.
Honestly. There's a lot of them that are totally just...
useless.
What's the point?
Mm. Or somehow do stuff to balance in some way that makes some sigils that are currently useless useful.
Yeah, sure. Like,
They can't fix dungeon rewards, so what makes you think they're going to do that?
Definitely all the sigils that are, like, plus 10% damage to drakes or something have to go. Because the way sigils work, where you have to replace it in your sword, it's just, no, why? They're 2 silver on the trading post for a reason, because that's the lowest you could possibly list them for, because nobody wants them. I don't know. Mm. Maybe people probably use them in very specific cases.
They used to use certain ones for dungeon runs, but...
Yeah. Yeah, dungeon
runs.
Like
Undead, for example, was used. Mm-hmm.
So if you had a character that all they ever did was dungeon runs, you would put it
on that. Well, you'd have an alternate weapon, right?
Right.
Exactly. But I think what they should do is, okay, they make Sigil of Blight. Okay, no one uses this piece of shit sigil because it doesn't do anything. It's terrible.
And what does it do?
It does an AoE poison attack with a long cooldown. It's like 2 stacks of poison in an AoE on crit, I think. It might be on hit. It's either on hit or on crit.
I've never heard of this. This is a sigil or a rune?
A sigil. And what they need to make it is they need to make it a poison field. So the daredevils can whirl through them going crazy and get loads of poison bolts for that synergy with their amazing poison damage.
There you go.
Yeah.
Problem with that is you still couldn't use it. Because you need agony for bleed duration, and you need malice, because they don't have a bleed trait, and they have a poison trait that doesn't work correctly.
But is the sigil blade a combo field? No, eh?
A lot of them need reworking. It is basically the gist of it, or just straight up removal. I know people don't like things removed from the game, but there's a lot of them that are just they never get taken.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Feels bad, man.
So they're going to fix mega servers, and John Smith is doing that.
Ah, yes.
Good luck.
So they're going to do the thing so it doesn't just close new maps for no reason.
Yeah, the Economist is going to fix the mega servers.
Seems
well,
legit.
Him and some other people.
Yeah. Well, the statistician, let's say, is going to fix the mega servers. But one big pair made a point that didn't get answered, that instead of megaservers, megaservers are still a thing and should exist always, but there should still, what about the option of districts?
They sort of answered that, I think, at one point, and they said that megaservers are kind of like districts, except that, of course, you can't select a specific megaserver. Mm-hmm. And I think he said, I'd have to go and dig up that response, but they did say something to the effect of, that wasn't doable currently for some reason.
Why?
Something to do with the way things are currently set up.
Huh. Okay.
I'd have to go digging. There was a response about that, though, and as to why it's not exactly like the Guild Wars 1 district system. That would be something that I guess they'd have to work on more or something.
Mm-hmm. I wish districts still existed.
I mean, it really should work that way, right? You should be able to say, okay, you know, District 5, everybody, you want to do this, go to District 5.
Like, I feel like mega servers exist because they wanted to make it so that as many people as possible be lumped into the right area that you would get to play with your friends and it would be fuller than usual. And it worked. It worked for a while. I don't know what the problem is currently with it in the HOT maps, but apparently there's a lot of empty maps and you keep on getting switched here and there. But with districts, it could still work that way. Like you would have, let's say, for every given map, you'd have maybe a base of three districts available, and you would still be lumped into the primary district or the district that would be best for you based on who your friends are and what guilds you're in. And then from there, you could choose to go wherever you want. And let's say you wouldn't open up new districts until all the three that you're currently in are full up. It would open up new districts only after that. And you could then go to District 4 if all the other three are full. But I guess I just don't understand exactly how mega servers work, because maybe there's something intrinsic in the way mega servers work that make it so that districts itself are completely impossible. But I haven't figured that out yet.
I don't know. I just think it takes more development work on their end to make it possible to choose those servers.
Exactly.
Some of these servers, they talk about them spinning up and down. That means that they're kind of virtual servers, at least in some capacity. Mm-hmm. So a virtual server spins up, you populate it. When it gets to a certain level, it wants to spin itself down to save resources. Right now, I think what's happening is there's some problem where that threshold is too low, or it's getting a false reading and it thinks that it should be closing, and so it kicks you out. Obviously, there's some kind of problem within either the coding or the way the server spins up and down right now for the newer maps.
Yeah.
I think a bit of the problem with the mega servers is that I think there's a certain attitude in people who play the maps that instead of even trying, if it looks like the map is not going to be a really easy map, people will just give up and just try and hop to another map instead.
Right.
You know, so people won't stay. They won't, instead of setting up their own map and trying to taxi people in, the overwhelming majority want to just jump to a map that's going to basically play itself and then AFK for a while. What?
Does that mean? Did I just freeze?
What? What's up?
No freezing.
No freezing? No, you're still moving for us.
Yeah.
Can you hear us? Internet's good today. Oh, Boots, can you hear us?
It's probably my internet because Inks and Teapots, camera's fuzzy.
Nobody's fuzzy for me.
Okay, yeah.
Teapot's a little bit fuzzy.
Okay. Boots, can you hear us?
I could barely hear you guys.
Huh. Boots!
No! What a disaster.
They really do need to have a district system, though. They need to fix whatever the problem is as to why that doesn't currently exist. They need to figure out how to make it exist and get that to work, because that would solve at least some of the issues that people are currently experiencing. It definitely would, especially for like, and I know this is probably a lot smaller player base than it seems like, but for those guilds who are trying to organize their own maps or trying to organize triple trouble kills or shatter or whatever, Arc Basin, for example, it would make it much easier for them to organize that and say, join District 6 or whatever if you want to do this, right?
Yeah.
It makes finding those maps a lot easier.
To a certain extent, though, with the LFG, you have something a bit like that, though, because they will be Tangled Depths, Tier 4, but join and leave, shit like that. I mean,
sort of, yeah.
Yeah, so there is something fairly similar, but yeah, you're absolutely right. It's not as simple as just you select a drop down, and then you join the map, and then you're good to go. But it seems unlikely that that will be returning, I think. I just don't see it. Anyway, Boots, what were you going to move on to?
I don't know. I could barely see you guys.
Oh, no.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. You're actually pretty clear. You're actually fine. On our end, anyway. On my end, at least.
On my end, my internet's terrible, I guess, right now. Oh, starting to hear you better?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to try to find... I closed down basically everything else I was doing on the internet to see if I could get you guys back. And I guess it kind of worked. But it means that I lost all my tabs.
No.
So hold, yeah, hold on a second. Okay, back here. So, HOT maps, change blah, blah, blah. Getting adventures to be more available. That's good. Achievements looked at, whatever. Items. Bringing old PvP skins back, which is nice. Probably working on it.
There's a number of skins. And I know the PvP ones are the big sticking point for people. The tribal armor, for example.
I want that so bad.
There's Why? A lot of people. You're not alone. Because he doesn't it's have it. And nice. it's a cool skin. But there's also a number of weapon skins, especially for the underwater ones, but also non-underwater ones that are in the wardrobe that you simply can't get in the game as well. So a bypass of that whole system would be nice if you can't get, for example, the Lion Guard harpoon gun for whatever reason, then that should just be removed from the wardrobe altogether. And then those armor skins that did actually exist, these are weapons that never existed within the game space. They exist within, like, I guess the code or whatever, but not actually available in the game. But armor skins that were in the game that went away with PvP when that was all changed over, tribal, and there's one or two others as well.
The tribal, and like some other shit.
Yeah,
the
tribal, they just though, bring it back.
Wasn't the tribal available from vendors? What happened to that?
Yeah, no, it was supposed to be part of the pack supply thing.
Yeah, no, it was tribal gear that when I was in, it was like early level heart quests that you talk to the heart vendor and you could buy a piece of tribal armor from it.
Is this the dry bone set?
Yeah, that's the dry bone set. Isn't that the tribal armor? No, right?
No.
Oh, okay, then never mind.
Different set.
Okay,
and
I look
and
at
part of Stalwart is available via story, or at least a piece or two of it is.
Mm-hmm.
But not the whole set.
Tribal armor. Let's look at this.
I mean, luckily, I got all those in PvP before it ended. But I know there's a lot of people that don't have them and that want them.
Yeah.
There's also a big outcry, too, and this is never talked about for some reason. There's a big outcry because I guess human females used to have a ton of idle animations.
They used to.
And they removed them for some unknown reason.
What were they?
They just like were idle animations anything? That I don't know.
I don't remember what they were.
Was it anything like the in WoW, the Blood Elf or the Dark Elf, not the Dark Elf, what are they called? The other elf. The Alliance elves.
Night elf?
Yeah, the Night Elves. Was it the Night Elves where they just, when they're standing around, they start bouncing?
Yeah, they do.
Was it something like that, that maybe they removed it for...
I don't know.
I don't think so. Reason? I don't know why they removed it. I don't know if they've ever discussed why they did. Mm. It was just they patched one time and it was...
They were gone.
Gone.
Yeah, I remember that. That was a highly upvoted Reddit post.
Yeah, it gets talked about quite a bit on the forums and on Reddit. People still ask, like, is this coming back? Why not just bring these back? Why? I don't know. If they have a legitimate reason for why they're gone or they removed them, they should just tell people this is why they were removed.
They have delinked fractal back pieces from the leaderboards and can release it sooner.
When?
Sooner.
Never.
Sooner than never?
Yeah, I mean, it's not soon, it's sooner. That's fantastic.
I mean, I know, like, it probably sounds like I'm being overly negative and a bit harsh, but it's great that they didn't ask me anything. I'm glad we got some information. But there's a couple of sticking points, like this fractal back piece that should have been released a long time ago. And I know they were working on fractal leaderboards that now, like Brazil said, just are not going to come. Ever, or not for a very long time.
I told everyone.
And well, they didn't listen to you, did they, Brazil? They thought you were crazy. They said that it was crazy.
Living World 3 not coming for a very long time. There's just a couple of disappointing facts when you hear the truth, I guess, behind it. And I'm glad we know the truth. It's far better to know than not know.
It makes me wonder what ArenaNet expected. Because it seems as though they worked really hard to get this expansion out on time and get it out for a certain date. And they did. They got it out for a certain date. But in the process, they promised a lot of things that were going to be in the expansion. And it was hyped up. Obviously, we hyped up the expansion, too, because we were getting all these this information that seemed fantastic. And they did do a lot of things they promised, but there's so much additional stuff that just didn't... I guess they didn't get it done in time. And it seems as though they knew they were not going to get it done in time, because now there's like a large wait until we could get a lot of this stuff. So they just kind of like dropped a bunch of stuff, didn't say that they were dropping a bunch of stuff to work on it after it got released.
And for some of that we knew, like for example, the legendary weapons, which I know there's quite a few people up in arms with how long that's taking. But we knew at release that we just weren't going to see very many of them. And that making new ones was going to require quite a bit of time because of the way that the scavenger hunt now works. So, like, I'm okay with that because we knew ahead of time. But, you know, this legendary back piece, for example, I don't know. And still, like, we don't have any kind of... And ArenaNet's not very big on telling you, like, exactly when it's going to come for obvious reasons. Mike O'Brien addressed this as to why they don't want to do that, because they don't want to say, yes, it's coming in April, and then things happen in development, and now it's not coming in April, and you get even more pissed off.
I mean, that's the whole reason why we probably have all these problems, is because the one thing that they had to tell us exactly when it would come was the expansion, and all right. Due to that, they weren't able to achieve all the goals they wanted for the expansion.
I think it just seems like they were traumatized by their original kind of fortnightly release thingy with the living story thingy. So now they've kind of gone to the other extreme. So now it's going to be very spaced out, you know, all the time. But whereas before they were just going crazy, just, you know, whipping the developers, work more. And they were pushing out content like crazy. But now...
I mean, to be fair, it's always been bad. It didn't matter if they had 2 weeks to do it or if they had a year like the expansion. It's been terrible every time.
Well, I don't know. I'm not sure if I'd agree with that. I kind of liked having fortnightly releases. It was really awesome. Even though
I'm not saying I didn't like the frequency wasn't better or worse. I'm just saying that the story has always been terrible. The characters have been bad. Like, I don't think there's been...
Even with that, even if you take that into consideration, I still kind of enjoyed all of it, honestly.
Yeah, I definitely enjoyed it.
There's more stuff to do.
Yeah, exactly.
Having more stuff to do is, I think, a better thing.
Yeah.
But it's like the quality of the story has just never been good.
Hmm.
It's like a high school playwriting class. That's brutal to say, but...
I really enjoyed season 2, though. I don't know. I can't say that I enjoy all the characters, because I don't feel like enough characters get enough spotlight time. And I think that's part of the problem with having so many characters to rebuild this guild team or whatever it is you want to call it. There's too many characters, not enough of them get spotlight time because there's not enough story to go around for all of them. You kind of need some side stories for some of them really to give them proper spotlight and development, but... There's just not enough resources and time for that kind of stuff, I guess.
Can we say that the reason why they introduced Destiny's Edge 2.0 was because they knew there was no way they'd be able to get the voice actors for Destiny's Edge 1.0 back all the times they needed it in the future?
Probably. Honestly, the voice actors that they got were probably like college students who had no chance of getting a job anywhere else, if I had to guess. And then they got the Jimmy Neutron voice actor to play Timmy, so...
Yeah, well, they didn't. We checked that up. But it does sound a lot like her, yeah. So they created Destiny's Edge 2.0, probably a financing issue, and also scheduling issue for all these people. But that obviously, like you're saying, Inks, raised huge problems, because now we have so many characters, it's hard to... concentrate.
Well, and what's interesting about that is we know from, I guess, other discussions that Felicia Day is one of the bigger ones that they had a hard time getting back into the studio for voice work, who does Zosia.
Mm-hmm.
Yet Zosia's still alive, or at least in some form, right?
Yeah.
Her and Logan are kind of like, you know, they've been slimed or whatever, but I don't know. That's kind of strange, right? She was the hardest one, apparently, to get back for voice work because of her busy schedule, whatever the case is.
Yeah.
And yet her character still seems to be semi-functional.
Yeah. Meanwhile, they could obviously get back Destiny's Edge 2.0 for work all the time.
Because they're probably unemployed.
Especially Timmy, because maybe it's just because she has a very distinctive voice, but I hear her voice every time an NPC uses that voice. Like, it's just like, there's Timmy, there's Timmy, there's Timmy, there's Timmy, there's Timmy, there's Timmy, there's Timmy. Even if it's trying to, I guess, sound a little different, it's not. It sounds exactly the same.
There's a couple characters like that.
Yeah.
Honestly, I'm just waiting to, like, drive through McDonald's someday, and when I'm at the drive-thru, I'll just say, oh, there's Timmy.
You're bad. You are terrible stuff. You're bad. Oh, my gosh.
I'm sorry.
I'm so bad. Oh, my gosh. It's not that bad.
With all this
you're terrible.
I'll tell you what, ArenaNet. First of all, you need a new game director. You probably need low-paid voiceover work. I need a job. I would do either one of those.
It was funny. There was like this. There was like an outpouring of like people saying, "Like, I'll be the game director for you." Sure. Go ahead, you be the game director. That would be a funny video. Just dress up in a suit and tie and be like, yes, I would like to be your next game director. Oh, fantastic.
I'll go get my tie right now.
Job application through Twitch.
It's
an interesting point because the raid team, as stuff going on in Twitch chat, the raid team is not a big team, yet they've done an amazing job. It's probably certainly from my perspective, raiding is the best thing about Heart of Thorns. There's no contest, it's not even close in any way. And yet they're one of the smaller teams. And here they are, they've got the second wing ready to go tomorrow, 2 days from now.
Tuesday, yeah.
Yeah, and then the third wing is already in a semi-playable state. I mean, these guys are on fire, right? This is pretty good.
Yeah, and they're like three people working.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I think that's fantastic.
It was
fantastic.
Like six, wasn't it?
It was a small number. Five or six. The thing is, raids, I was so blown away by the first one. There's a few things I'm worried about in Guild Wars 2 in the future. First of all, the fact that Living Story is coming so late, I'm a little worried about that. But I'm hoping, because it's coming so late, that it will be really good. Raids is like the one thing I am not at all worried about. They are good so far, and considering the fact that it was only five and six, or six people working over 4 months, which is about the amount of time I thought it would have been for a larger team to do that, fantastic. You, Crystal Reed, top-notch, and your team, I love you guys. You're amazing. Mm. And I have no worries whatsoever about the future ones. The next one's coming in 2 weeks, so maybe I'll change completely in the next 2 days. Hopefully not. I probably won't. So far, so good. You guys are great. But I'm a little worried about the length of time we're waiting for Living World 3.
Mm.
I'm also very worried about World versus World. I'm super worried about World versus World, because we haven't had that many updates to World versus World in general. The only large update we really had was that new map, and it only fell through because we don't have the population to hold it up. But
well, that's mostly, not the only reason.
The main reason is because there's not enough people in it, and the main reason there's not enough people in it is because when there's a small amount of people in it, nobody wants to be there. So, like,
do you think? So this is kind of an interesting question, perhaps. Perhaps. Do you think that that map should have been a central map rather than Borderlands?
Yeah, probably.
Because
there's
only
one of them.
Because it's so large, yeah, there would only be one of them then instead of... But then there's no central point necessarily.
No.
Like, there's a castle.
It'd have to be designed differently, yeah.
But
yeah.
Because the map is so large and because of the way the map actually works, I don't know that it makes a great Borderlands map. But anyway.
Yeah. I think it just discourages certain things that people want in World versus World. I think a lot of, I don't know, maybe I'm coming at this from the wrong direction. I don't play World versus World, but people like big fights and they like protracted engagements with,
and they don't like giant PvE events in the center of the map.
I've really always wanted to like World versus World. Honestly. Like, that was one of the first things I tried when I got into the game, and I thought it was cool, and I had fun, and it just, like, it's boring. It's just not good.
So hold on a second. The 5 to 6 people on the raid team not only designed the fights and everything, they designed maps. The maps, too?
Yes.
And
these guys are machines.
Holy crap.
Yeah, I know.
I believe, I might be wrong, I know for the first map anyway, I think Tirza worked on that map.
Obviously they used elements that were already pre-designed. Like they said, for Sabbath, the platform and the tree platform they were on was sort of already designed by Tirza. And we saw that in, I forget what map it was called, it was the one that was never released, that shaman with data mine with wooden potatoes. I forget what it's called. Anyway,
Fortune's Veil.
Fortune's Veil.
Yeah.
Spirit Veil.
Oh.
Damn! I don't have my Illuminati triangle anymore. Otherwise, I'd put that on my face.
See, everybody was complaining that they wasted all those. Jesus, that they wasted all those assets. You're wrong. They used them. See,
they used the assets. Yeah. In fact, forget. No. Anyway, the point is they used. Obviously, everybody designing most of Guild Wars 2 stuff nowadays is going to be using assets and making new maps using those assets, right? I mean, probably with the expansion, they had to create a whole new set of new assets. But for once those are created, it's a little bit easier to make maps. But it's still freaking impressive that 5 to 6 people were able to do that in 4 months. That's amazing.
Yeah, you know, like somebody's saying in chat, I'm sure that they, you know, they pull in a person here and there to shift, you know, some responsibility around to help with certain assets or whatever, but it's mostly that core team developing the raid stuff.
So it was 4 months for the first wing and some of the second wing, I think they said?
I don't remember.
Can we assume that maybe this team could put out a wing every 4 months, or is it an entire raid every 4 months?
I don't know.
I would assume possibly an entire raid, right? Because if they already have the third wing in testing or playable, that means they're going fairly fast.
Well, it depends how early in HOT development they started working on raiding, I guess.
That's a big part of it.
Because if they started at the beginning of the year of HOT, then they had 12 months, so that's 3 raids if we're going by that thing, and then that would be done. So
I don't think that's true. I don't think that's true at all. I would almost bet you that these people that are on the raid team were on different teams at the start of Heart of Thorns, and then at some point in that cycle formed into the raid team to build the raid.
Yeah.
I don't think it wasn't 12 months that they started working on the raid.
Fingerlights, yeah, I wasn't asking how many they're going to be putting out a year. I was just trying to composite, based on what they said, 5 to 6 people working for 4 months, how much they are able to put out in that timeline.
6 wings a year.
Yeah, it's two raids a year, basically, is what they said they're going to do.
I'd be pretty happy with that, quite frankly.
Yeah.
And they, again, they very
surprises me.
They're very conservative with their language, because they were saying that Spirit Veil was always supposed to have 3 wings, but not every raid will have 3 wings. So 3
wings.
You know, they're saying, maybe if we're under a bit of time pressure, we'll go with 2, or you know, something like that, or maybe even
right,
more.
And,
who knows?
Right, and not always 3 bosses, but the same amount of whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And that's just, you know, they're being careful with their language. But I would probably expect similar amounts of content in the future raids and wings and so on.
That means a wing every 2 months. And did we get that so far? We got one. When was the first wing released? About a month after HOT? January?
What was it?
No, it was released before. It was released in
December? December. Maybe. When was it released?
End of November, maybe, I think. Well, it was before the end of November because Thanksgiving. I remember taking a break for Thanksgiving, so it was before then.
I don't remember. Well, I know Heart of Thorns came out in October.
It released in November, I think.
17th of November.
17th of November.
There you go.
And so, Raid Wing 2 is coming out March 8th. So that is 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months later.
Yeah. So,
but
yeah, they may also have.
You also have a December's a dead month because they're.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, but if what Fingerlights was saying is true, they were saying six wings in a year. If we're saying December is a dead month, then that's six wings in 11th month, so that means a wing every less than 2 months.
They could, well, what I'm saying is mid-December to beginning of January is dead development time, more or less.
No, I understand.
Meaning that they could
release, let's say there's only 3 months that work.
Right, they could release a raid at the beginning of December. It's just no work is going to get done really until the beginning of January then.
Yeah.
Six no real
bosses
work.
A year.
Not no work at all, but, you know.
Six minor. Bosses a year? I don't think that's true.
Nah, because that would only be...
That would only be two wings.
Two wings a year. And that's
yeah. going to happen. No, that's wrong. Yeah, four wings seems more realistic. I think it's supposed to be two raids between expansions.
What? Oh, no.
That was what I understood.
Really?
So six wings between expansions? Because then that... Yeah.
There'll be a lot of expansions. Though.
Yeah.
That would be a lot of
pace
on expansions.
I wonder if fractal leaderboards will be in the next expansion.
Maybe they'll just kind of try and push that one under the rug and hope we forget about it.
I mean, they've mentioned it 5 times already.
Well, I'm okay with that.
Or maybe it's the carrot on the stick. They're just kind of...
fractals are literally a carrot on a stick.
Well, they also gave us a dev breakdown. There's 120 devs working on the live team, the live game. Yeah. 70 currently working on the expansion. Those numbers will transition as they get closer to that expansion. But then what does that say about the expansion? When are we getting the next expansion then, do you think?
2 years.
2 years from now?
2 years from now.
I don't think
so. I don't think there's going to be another one.
I think if they have people working on it, they're not going to scrap that completely.
I don't think there's going to be another expansion.
I don't think that's true.
I think everyone is going to quit and go to Amazon.
I think the... Zill, what's wrong with you?
he's just there kind of lurking down here. Time to troll.
Yeah, that's it. No, it's impossible that there's not going to be another expansion because of the fact that they are putting a lot of funds into it.
They're putting a lot of funds into esports too. Oh! That's taken off.
And they're still going on. They're happening. They're happening. I mean, the money's still going there. It's not like they're not still trying. It doesn't, even if the expansion comes out, it's going to be maybe it'll be a dud. But the point is that they're still putting it out there. They're still putting
it out there. You can't handle it.
That was
I think we're going to get an expansion announcement next year.
I think I'm with Inks on this one.
Yeah, I think so too.
I think we all agree.
Actually. I don't know that it'll be in January, but it'll be sometime next year.
I think expansion every 2 years. I was hoping there's going to be more than one season of Living Story between that, or two seasons of Living Story between that, but it doesn't look like it. Anyway. The point is, Brazil, 70 people working on something, that's a lot of money going into it. They're not going to completely scrap it. It's impossible that they do that.
I'm expecting another one.
Point has Guild Wars 2 been out for so long that they have to do Guild Wars 3?
Oh, I see.
Well, how long has World of Warcraft been out?
Guild Wars 1 was out for 10 years. How long has WoW been around?
The thing is, the thing is about Blizzard is that they are very good at polishing a turd. Unbelievably good at it, actually.
You're absolutely right. It is a poor analogy on my part, but there's not going to be a Guild Wars 3 anytime soon.
There's barely a Guild Wars 2 at this point.
But what I mean is, I don't see Guild Wars 2 surviving in the same way that the cockroach that is WoW has survived. I mean, you can't kill WoW. It's just unkillable. They always seem to have people playing.
There's not a ton of MMOs. That's a poor statement, too. A lot of the MMOs that exist currently are not looking towards making a second version of themselves.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen nearly as often as you would think.
Absolutely.
The game usually just either dies or continues on forever.
Guild Wars 3 will move to DX10 from DX9.
Finally.
Meanwhile, the rest of the world will be on DX16.
Yeah.
I think right now, Guild Wars 2 players in general, are going through a very difficult transition phase. We were used to two-week cadence, then we were used to two-week/large break cadence, and now we're back to we're now on quarterly updates, which isn't like the end of the world, but these quarterly updates have to be big.
They have to actually be quarterly too.
They have to be big impact on the game when they actually happen. And I think, you know, a year from now, and I know this is going to sound terrible, but a year from now, I think the game could be in a really solid place. But it's in a shaky place right now, and we have to wait for these quarterly patches to see how that's going to shake out.
Mm-hmm.
April's going to be extremely telling to see what that all includes, right? And,
it's not going to be good.
I know.
They're going to have to fuck it up 7 times before they get the idea of what to do to make it better.
April's going to be a lot like our last quarterly patch, but it's going to be with the promise of, in the next couple of months, we're going to be doing these tests, we're going to be doing these things. These are going to be rolling out very soon. Just hold on a second. But April itself, no, that's that. The April patch is not going to be that monumental, I don't think.
It could be big for the game if they fix the Heart of Thorns content that exists. I know some people are already tired of it, have already played it. I'm sure lots of people watching this are frequent players. But those people who are maybe less frequent, who are being detracted from the game right now because of the way the Heart of Thorns maps work, reworking that content could bring at least those players back in to play that content.
I mean, I don't even know about that. Because, like, I feel like loyal players who enjoy the game and, like, the experience will come back. People who don't really get that attachment, they'll just get tired of it, and then, I mean, it'll be done. Like, they just won't have a reason to come back.
Hmm.
What game/MMO will I play if Guild Wars 2 doesn't make it a year from now? I will probably just move on to doing stuff in real life. I'll probably just be done with games after Guild Wars 2, honestly.
Fair enough. Feels bad, man. So, if you wanna keep Brazil around, go out there and sell some copies of Guild Wars 2. You know, you gotta resurrect the game.
Mm-hmm. You know?
Give the game an AED or a rebound. If every Tempest in Guild Wars 2 uses rebound at the same time, will it resurrect everything in the game?
I think so.
Maybe it will save esports.
The thing about Guild Wars 2, where it is right now, I'm with Inks a little bit, because even though it seems like nothing's really happening, it feels like they're much more stable in what they know they want to do. Because in the last three, like the first 3 years of Guild Wars 2, it seemed as though they were sort of like going back and forth trying to figure themselves out.
And yeah, it was like a high school student that just went to college And exactly. They didn't know if they were bisexual or not.
That's it. Asexual now knows it's bisexual.
Weirdest analogies.
Amen.
Weirdest analogies.
But so that's it. So they were figuring themselves out, and now they know what they're capable of and what they can put out. So they've organized themselves in such a way that they will try to be successful in this method going forward. So it's living world stuff, raids, hopefully getting people back into World versus World and fractals, good. And then chopped up by expansions every now and then. And they've committed their people to it, and hopefully it works out. So now we know exactly what we're getting for the next 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 years, let's say. The question is, are we all on board?
They ask me anything, and even the Road Ahead post that we got a couple of months ago was all about this entire year is going to be about polish of the game that already exists. There will be some new content here and there, obviously Raid Wings, a fractal or two, but it's mostly World vs. World, but it's mostly going to be about polishing the game that exists and polishing Heart of Thorns. There's going to be a lot of people that are unhappy with that because they want, you know, tons and tons of new content. I definitely understand that, but this year is going to be a lot about polish and making the game that exists better than it is.
Yeah. And it seems as though they've at least, I don't know what's going to come with. I really hope Living World Season 3 changes my perspective. But it seems as though they're going to keep the big expansions, new maps, etc., into actual expansions rather than Living World now. I might be wrong, though.
We'll have to wait and see for that one, honestly. But the thing is, though, they're polishing the game, but then they also have to actually make stuff as well. Because polish is all very well and good if you haven't done everything. But if you have done everything, you're kind of sitting here twiddling your thumbs, waiting for them to actually drop something. So,
And Heart of Thorns wasn't it really wasn't a huge content dump that a lot of people needed or wanted. So, yeah, I understand. I do.
So, we've been on for 2 hours. Do you think it's time for questions, or...
Well, 7-Bit Brian has been asking the same question a couple of times.
We need to answer that. He wants to know our actual thoughts on esports, is what he wants to know.
Oh. I gave my actual thoughts last week.
Which so go was... watch that!
Yeah!
Yeah, go watch that anyway.
Go check it out.
My actual thoughts were that... they've been trying for 3 years. It's not really worked yet. It probably won't work in the future, but they have to keep trying.
They're committed now.
They have to keep trying, no matter what. No, even if people in chat always make fun of them, even if they only get 4,000 people watching on Twitch,
they have to do.
They have to keep trying because
you know
it's the only way to keep the PvP people in the game, and they need the PvP people in the game. And as long as there's prizes, as long as they could set aside a certain amount of money every year for these prizes for these PvP people to entice more people to join the game for that reason, then it's worth it.
So here's the thing about this 7-Bit Brian. You claim it's not working, but they're making money off of it. I mean... there's a very big difference between getting 4,000 viewers on a Guild Wars 2 ESL stream and, like, Athene playing Minecraft getting 10,000 viewers. Like, I mean, they're investing a lot into it, and the balance of the game is terrible, and there are, like, 25 pro PvP players, and no one knows who they are. Like, I could tell you who Ostrich Eggs is because I used to farm him in PvP and he's not good. But that's, like, the only one I know. I guess there's Hellsith, too. But, like, I can't tell you any of the team names. I can't fucking tell you hardly any of the players. I just don't know. And I keep up with the game a whole lot.
And, like, I mean, maybe everyone on this stream is the same. Maybe they're not. Like, people in the fucking chat that are watching, I have no idea. Like, esports, maybe they're investing into it. Maybe they're making money off of it. Sure, that's a possibility. But, like, is it vain? Is it in vain? Like, I don't know. Like, it's just, it's not in vain. It's not going to catch on.
It's maybe not in vain because if they weren't doing this, the PvP scene would dwindle out for sure. So it's not in vain because it keeps the PvP scene at least a little vibrant. And on a personal level, I really like looking at the all the competitions they have. It's a lot of fun to watch sometimes when it's not the past meta. The past meta was just terrible. But it's fun to watch sometimes. I really like
sometimes.
It.
Sometimes. I think I think they need to fix. I think they need to develop the camera system a lot more to make it more enjoyable to watch. That's one thing. Mm. There's lots of other little things I'm sure that people have much better input than me as to how to make it a more enjoyable experience to watch. But Brazil's not wrong in that the pro player base that does exist. There's just not enough. I guess emphasis put on that. Like, not enough people know about it. But it also depends what ArenaNet wants out of this. How many viewers do they expect to get? Are they meeting their expectations? Because so, like, you could have a TV show, right? And the TV show might get 1.6 million views. And depending on the network, that might be fantastic. And they might keep that TV show for 7 years. But if you put that on a primetime network, it'll get canceled after one episode or two episodes, right? They'll just get rid of it like that. Yeah. So it depends what ArenaNet as a company wants out of their esports. How many views do they expect to get? Is that view growing? Is it stagnant? Is it shrinking?
I would, if we're going to do the TV show analogy, I would say that esports for Guild Wars 2 is less of a rating system as the qualifier of whether or not they should do this TV show. It's more of like the TV show we should relate it more to is like Dragon's Den or The Apprentice or something like that. Sure. Where sure the ratings are important, but at the same time it has its own purpose. Doing it in itself has its own purpose. The advertisement, the getting more sponsors onto it. There's more than just the amount of people watching it that matter for this kind of thing.
Sure, I agree. I'll put it this way, too. I guess that's a good point. Maybe the way I should have phrased it is that it feels like they're trying to make it so much bigger than maybe they're actually trying to make it. Because, like, Grouch goes crazy about it on Twitter, and, everybody goes crazy about it. They're, like, 10 people that just go absolutely nuts, and everyone else is just like, okay, esports.
Esports.
Like, it feels like they're trying to make it into this whole show, like, big thing. Like, now we have leagues, but it's, I think maybe they're overdoing it. I don't know. Like, I don't have access to the metrics that they do. I'm just a person who has played the game for 10,000 hours and likes the game and has invested a whole lot of everything into the game and will probably continue to play the game. But I just don't care about the esports, and I feel like I'm probably not alone. I can't tell you, like I said, pro players, like meta builds for shit. Like, I just don't care. Like, I did PvP for, like, 2 days the other day because I needed AC tokens. Because it's just not interesting to me. Like, watching Guild Wars 2, watching, like, PvP streams, what? You don't know what's happening. Like, even the dungeon streams, like, the dungeon tournaments we did, like, if I didn't play dungeons, if I only did PvP, I'd probably have no idea what was going on. Because it's just like, what the hell is this? They're whatever. But, I mean, those were moderately successful.
This is our chance, Inks. You know what this means. You know what you need to make PvP? So everyone knows what's going on? Make it really obvious? Stronghold. That's exactly what we need. Oh, yeah. Stronghold will save esports. And I know 7-Bit Brian, he loves this shit as well.
I can't play Stronghold.
It will
save esports. You just need a middle lane.
Stronghold enrages me.
Save esports.
You just need a middle lane for Stronghold. The middle lane while where the guys go up against each other. Where you send things. When you send things from your places, you can send it to your lane that doesn't have people coming against it. You can send it to the middle lane where it does have a possibility of other archers coming against it or something. Two doors to every keep.
I think, you know, then this goes back to the whole camera thing. If you just jump into a Guild Wars 2 stream to watch it, it's, I think if you don't know the game, even if you know the game, sometimes it's hard to pick up what the hell is going on or why you should be as excited as Jebro because something's happening on a particular point or whatever the case is, what's happening in the game itself. It's kind of difficult to follow, and that's part of the problem of its success. If people can't just jump in and watch and sort of understand what's going on because they're not, like, how are you going to interest new players to it or interest people outside of
it? That's the same thing about all sports. I mean, if I start watching football and I'm like, who cares? What is this? Nobody cares. It's the same thing for all sports. It's like it's going to be the same thing for all video game esports too. Like I don't want to watch League of Legends because I don't really care about what the
character. Yeah, but you can't tell. But you can't tell, like, you know, someone says, oh, this awesome interrupt or whatever just happened. You can't see it really.
When someone uses their ultimate ability in League or Dota, you know it's happened.
Right.
Every single profession in Guild Wars 2 needs to be a Reaper with Greatsword. And then it'd the game cool. is suddenly amazing. Because you have these giant people just swinging around, flailing. You have the ridiculous ice explosion shout just going crazy everywhere. That's what you need. Suddenly now
it would
the game
be cool
is
if the casters had the ability to, like, pause and rewind the live game and, like, do replays of what just happened. That would be cool.
I'm pretty sure they do that in League of Legends.
Yeah, I know. It would be very good in Guild Wars 2 to do that. It's probably even more important than League of Legends because just to comprehend something important that just happened.
Like, I think I would rather see World versus World as an esport over Conquest PvP. I think it would be easier to follow because you just have
2 weeks.
Huge fucking long. Balls of shit just killing each other. And, like, you're not going to be able to tell what's happening anyways, so that doesn't matter. And then you see, like, oh, God, this huge group of people puts it in there taking the keep, and they just wipe this whole, whatever. Like, I don't know. That would be more interesting to me than watching just, like, Clown Fiesta, Elementalist, and Mesmers just not doing anything on a point for 10 years. Mm. So.
Yeah, I guess that's my point, right? It's a lot of visual noise. You can't see exactly what's happening.
And sometimes
it's not even, I don't even think it's a visual noise.
It's sometimes inappropriate visual noise. There's some really impactful abilities right. get completely unnoticed. And then you have right. these kind of irrelevant abilities that have these massive effects and they just don't do anything. Really. I mean, like the Tempest shouts, you know, you have these, you know, a massive wave of fire coming out and it applies one burn stack. I mean, you're kidding me, Arena. It's just, what is this shit? And Rebound, you know, Rebound is kind of boom, a big effect that's just got massive visual noise everywhere. And it's kind of, it's not impactful. Whereas there's some other stuff that just, you know, it's a huge deal. Like Corrupt Boon, you know, Corrupt Boon,
It's
a huge deal. And, you know, you'll see the commentators go, oh my god, the massive Corrupt Boon. But it's just kind of a little wiggle, isn't
it? The tell is...
Yeah, that's all it is. Any comments on the GVG tournaments that ESL is bringing? I mean, people have wanted GVG for ages.
They should not even try. They should not even make an attempt.
I don't know. I think it might hit the sweet spot of what people wanted.
Are they going to get enough people to actually sign up for GVG?
Well, the problem is that it's been so long.
They actually have a good system in place before they try it. And they're trying it right now with a very bad system.
Oh, okay. That's bad. And the other problem is that a lot of the big, like the guilds that used to do all the GVGs have sort of petered out.
Quit the game because there's nothing for them to do.
Yeah.
Apparently there's already 7 15 versus 15 ESL GVG games.
Holy shit.
Be interesting.
7 teams. Not
in fairness, people have been asking for this for ages, right?
It's pretty good. That's way more, believe it or not, that's way more than I thought they already had signed up.
So I wonder.
That's good.
I wonder if that's going to be any easier to see what's going on in.
No.
I think it might be a bit worse, actually, Boots. I think
maybe,
it might
maybe about three times worse.
Yeah.
I hope that they like stream it and stuff, so I can see what that ends up looking like.
I really think this is something that Guild Wars 2 needs to get on top of. There are lots of tournaments, okay, that just don't get streamed, and they get more interest. They get more teams even participating in them just by streaming them. I think because suddenly everyone's aware of them all the time. Because right now, I mean, I'm just going to say it. When I entered a Stronghold tournament, there wasn't even an admin in the arena. We could have totally rigged the games, and we would have got away with it. We could have said, yeah, they win, fine.
And you didn't even get your gems for it, did you?
Not yet. No. But, you know, that's irrelevant, you know. Time takes time, you know.
Why would anyone have any incentive to do it if there's a reward promise and they never get the reward? That's been the case with every single thing they've done, like Pug Quest and all that shit. Like, yeah, win a llama, win whatever, and you get it like 4 months later.
Why does it take so long?
I don't know. Like, I can't explain why everything they do takes so long. Like, living story, fixing the dungeon rewards, giving out llamas...
I mean, if you're going to have a tournament with rewards, you need to hand those rewards out the day of the tournament, or maybe the next day at the very least, not months later. Like, that would anger me, too, if I was involved in that. I would be pretty upset if I played in a tournament and did well, were placed in prize. Can you imagine playing in a poker tournament and they say, don't worry, we'll send you your winnings in like 6 months. You'll get a check. There's no way. There's no way.
Yeah. There was a question some time ago. Can we give a brief rundown of the current state of the game? Because a person had took a 4 month break. No, they have returned.
Well, hey, if you took a 4 month break,
you're good to go.
At all? Yeah.
Heart of Glass came out.
Honestly, yeah. If you haven't done any of HOT, you're gonna have a really good time. Because you've got your elite specializations. Wow, new memes. You've got all the world events in HOT. They'll be fun for the, doing the maps for the first time is going to be epic for you because the events are actually pretty cool. Doing Dragon Stand is going to be epic. You're going to enjoy it a lot for the first time. And then you'll be grinding Crystalline or Ellie Giggle. And then you've got raids. Wow.
Raids are fun.
And the raids are great. And the good news is that if you get HOT right now, you'll probably be done with all the content that you wanted to do by the time Living World 3
comes out. Yeah, the new stuff comes out, yeah. So, honestly, if you're coming at the game now as a new player, the game is better than it's ever really been. Okay, the PvP balance is a little bit wonky right now, but, you know, that's not so bad.
It's way better than it was.
Yeah, but that's the only thing, really. If you're returning, there's never been a better time to come back, honestly. Or start playing, or whatever. Yeah. K-Fizzle quit Guild Wars 2 PvE because of Crystalline Ore.
I don't blame you.
I mean, those rewards in general for those maps are pretty...
redonkulous.
Yeah.
Mm. But hopefully April they change it properly. Just unfortunately it'll be too late for me.
it won't be too late for me. I haven't done it.
Yeah,
I actually think the new maps are very efficient for getting rewards.
Except for Crystalline Ore.
Except for that, yeah. But other than that, yeah. I think they're actually pretty efficient.
Airship parts aren't that much better.
Really, I feel they're pretty easy.
You have to run around and open
just open boxes. That's pretty
open
easy.
Boxes.
Like I will literally go into Verdant Brink for 3 hours at a time
just
and
running
so
around.
Airship. I love it. It's so fun.
Yeah, I like opening things. I love
I wish I got airship parts for doing the things that I'm
just,
in
just
doing.
Just think of it, Inks. It's like opening booster packs. Whenever you get 75 airship parts out of one, it's like getting a holo.
There you go.
So, shall we wrap it?
Yeah, I think we can do that now.
Wrap it up in a body bag and bury it in the ground.
Yes, sounds just like good. My internet provider.
God,
oh,
whatever
yeah.
you do, don't... I know Rex is sort of joking, but WoW, I tried to go back, you know, sort of off topic, but I tried to go back to WoW last year. What a fucking mess. Oh, God.
I think this is probably the first time I'm not going to buy the WoW expansion on launch, actually, or ever, actually. I'm not really feeling it this time.
All right.
Yeah.
God.
But WoW is a great game. It is an excellent game.
I could tangent about WoW, but I don't think I will. I think we'll just wrap it up.
I'm not gonna shit talk WoW. I got a lot of enjoyment out of that game. I got a lot of enjoyment out of Warlords as well.
Years.
Years. Massive amount of value out of Warlords. I definitely don't regret playing it a lot. It's an excellent game.
Not Warlords for me, but WoW in general. Years of entertainment.
Yeah, there have been better. The glory days of WoW have, to a certain extent, passed. But that's because
I played WoW for 15 minutes.
Yeah. But that's because you got a guild invite and that triggered you or some shit.
I installed the game. I made a blood elf, and I installed the game. I came in and immediately got spammed by guild invites and gold sellers. I just logged out and uninstalled it. Never played it again. Done.
Fair enough. You go.
Yeah.
You don't get free content updates with WoW, but such is life.
So I'm World of Enders, and I really want to end the show for some reason.
Yeah. He has to go.
If you want to follow me, Google I'm an impatient ass.com.
Oh, wow. Brutal.
Brazil's
Brazil's
a little savage today.
Yeah, he is.
I'm a little brutal. It's fine.
A little brutal. Brutal.
No, let's talk for another 45 minutes.
All right.
But you have questions?
Yeah. My impatience is as big as my nose.
Question. Oh, wow. What the hell, man?
Man.
Wow. Oh, boy.
Maybe we should end before I start getting a little too crazy.
I'm glad it's Boots, not me.
Yeah, I know.
I like
lethal.
that's how you know Brazil likes you.
And that's how I know he likes Nike.
I love Nike. I agree. Nothing bad to say about
it. Here's a thing. One of Nemesis's followers entered Mystic Builds. Okay.
Patrish?
Yeah. And you know there was he came up with this stake that if he won, I would have to remove Nike from my friends list, and also he'd be moderator. But he lost, so I managed to get away with that. Yeah, I thought, oh shit, I'm gonna have to do it now. I didn't actually agree, but, you know, he just said, you have to do it. He said you have to do it. And the problem is, if he said it in Twitch chat, if I didn't do it, they would just riot or let the bears in or something. There'd be bears all over chat. It would just get crazy. There you go. There's a funny story. It was close, but, yeah, not like this. Anyway, so, Bootzil, why don't you outroduce yourself?
Hi everyone, I'm Brazil. I'm going to look into the webcam for this, so that shows that I care a whole lot. Follow me on Twitter at BrazilGW2, and if you want to find anything else about me, including probably my real name at this point, since that got leaked out, just Google BrazilGW2 and I'm sure you'll find it. So, there we go.
When did it get leaked? Where can I find
it? I uploaded a video where I was signed into the game, and it had my name in it.
Brutal.
There we go.
Damn. What about you, Inks? Let's go to the top here. We'll finish in the middle.
Twitter, Twitch, and YouTube, MMO Inks.
Moinks.
Moinks.
Okay. Do that. Go ahead and follow. And here we have another fine gentleman, esteemed philosopher, who is... removed his glasses.
Staring into the camera.
Because he cares.
Eye contact.
What about you, Boots?
Hi. I'm Bootsper. You can find me at youtube.com/worldofenders. That's WORLDOFENDERS.
Hi, my name's Boots, and I look like Bert from Sesame Street.
No, thank you very much. When I was a kid, I looked like Ernie. I had a picture of me when I was 1 year old. And I was like the fattest 1 year old you've ever seen in your life.
I was skinny.
That's probably what happened. It happens like that. It switches.
Yeah.
And yeah, so I was like a chubby 1-year-old, and I was wearing like a striped shirt, just like Ernie. And it was just, that's Ernie. It was pretty bad. Anyway, Teapot, how about you?
Well, you won't have a difficult time finding me, seeing as you're already here. If you can't find this stream, something is going wrong. You've got problems. I mean, at this point, it is a mandate. If you actually read the Guild Wars 2 TOS, it says you have to follow the stream. So go ahead and do that. Otherwise you'll get banned. That is obviously untrue, right. But do it anyway. Yeah, you can also go on YouTube. I do retarded shit like 40-minute Veil Guardian kills. It's pretty great. That Fantastic. Was fun. Definitely need to do more stuff like that.
Stay and tuned Yolo Mouse the violates the terms of service.
Wait, what does?
Because it injects a DLL.
Oh.
Oops.
Rip.
Yolo Mouse violates the TOS.
Yolo Mouse.
I don't know what that is. What is Yolo What's Mouse?
That? Some
what?
Stupid program that people use.
What is it? What does it do?
I don't know.
Oh, okay.
I just know it violates.
All right.
Anyways.
Yes.
Bye, everybody.
Goodbye, friends. Let's host someone, I guess.